thank you, DJ. I'm still a beginner in this dancing game. Yeah. How are you guys? You see, when we are performing, you're taking pictures. Where do you work, ma'am? Taking videos. Where do you work? I want to go. You work at ShopRite, ne? I want to go to ShopRite. When you are busy working, I'm following you with a video like this. Then you know that you're abusing us. Hello, Namibia. How are you? It's nice to be here. It's nice to be here. I'm excited, actually. I'm excited. I don't have good news from South Africa. Nothing, nothing. We've had people dying because of the cyclones in Durban. And we had others resurrecting on the other side. Like, sir, did you hear about the guy who died and was resurrected and he died again? Did you hear about that one? You know, I know what the problem is here. With our South Africans, we want things to be gradual. You don't just die. Because the guy was shocked himself. Before we were even shocked, he was shocked. You're like... So I think the best thing, after you die, you don't go straight to like resurrection, like full recovery. Just die, from there go to ICU, then go to the normal ward, then walk on a wheelchair or crutches, then we welcome you back to the community. Don't just go papa, no, it's too quick. In South Africa, we like stages, even with load shedding, we accepted it because load shedding's got stage one, stage two. I don't know if you know load shedding. Load shedding is when you don't have electricity, you're out of the blue, like it's dark, dark, dark. You know about e-tolls, right? You don't know e-tolls? Okay, let me leave that one. Let me get to the part I know best. I'm from Eastern Cape. I'm from Eastern Cape, not Joburg. I stay in Joburg now, but originally I'm from a small town in Eastern Cape called Whittlesea. Very, very, like very small. The population is exactly the size of the number of people in this room. Like 1, 2, 3, 4. Exactly 42. The nicest thing about coming from a small town is that there's no crime. I know that South Africa is known for crime, but where I come from, the small town, very few. We know each other, all of us. So even if you come to me at 12 midnight wearing a mask, I go, I hate it, but this is you. Ay, those ears, Baba. It's you, it's you, it's you. Stop it. Stop it. There is no choice but to unmask and confess. I can't say, yeah, it's me, man. You must not walk at night. At this time, we're very busy robbing people. Hello, you are late for the show. I used to be a teacher. I used to deal with people like you. People who are late. Honestly, it's very nice. No one is robbing anyone. Unlike Johannesburg. Hey! You must go there. You will tell me. They come to you. They're not wearing any masks because you'll never even notice. But there's something about crime in Joburg. Criminals are very, very smart. They will take your phone. You won't even be aware that your phone is gone. Until you're at home, you want to make a call, your phone is gone. Have you ever been robbed by someone so smart that you want to go back to them just to give them a compliment? But hey, my brother, hey, I've been robbed before, but when you were born for this, man. You must give a compliment where it is due. Sometimes this thing is a talent, guys. Sometimes this is, but then you must understand, I used to be a teacher. I could see a criminal from age 7 in my class. You're gonna be a problem. But the bad thing about being a teacher is that you're not allowed to be honest. You can see good eye, this one now. But you have to pretend as if you are seeing something good here. Especially during parents' meetings. Parents will come to you and ask you, hello ma'am, how is Temba doing? That time Temba's not doing at all. But you have to lie to this parent and say, hey, ma'am, you know, I think Temba needs some time. You know, no amount of time can help outside, you feel like saying, can you just buy Temba a taxi? So that Temba can go and be useful somewhere. Because Temba is wasting my time. I had to leave teaching. I was tired of lying. All the time. You give a child a test, you give a child a test, the child gets 3/50. But you're not allowed to say, you are stupid. You have no future here. You have to say, hey, you must study. You know this kid, study won't do anything here. And so I left and became a stand-up comedian. That's why I'm standing right now. Thank you. I taught those kids for 11 years. They never clapped hands for me, not even once. You see, I should have taught you. You give me that power. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And so I'm doing comedy now. Eish, I love comedy. Comedy has helped me to travel the world. Last year, July, I was in London because of comedy. Clap hands, don't be jealous. I enjoyed East London. I don't care what you're thinking to. To me. Guys, to me. London is London to me. If it's East, West, I don't care. I was there in East London. Because when you are here in Windhoek, is it Windhoek? Whether it's Windhoek West, Windhoek South, you are there. So I was there in London. Here in South Africa, it's London, London. London is London. Don't care. But I would have loved, you know, and I would have, to be honest, I would have loved to go to the London that we're thinking about. But my problem is that I'm scared of aeroplanes, guys. I'm scared of aeroplanes. The day they have a Quantum from South Africa to London, I'll be there, front seat, ma'am. Front seat. Till then, I'll stick to that East London. Telling you. But there are so many things that I hate. When people ask me stupid questions about teaching, like, Kanye, sir, is it true that teachers earn peanuts? I'm like, you are mad. You think I can go to work for the whole month for a bag of peanuts? No, we earned money. We didn't go to the ATM, got 5 kg peanuts. No. We got money like everyone else. And people ask me, what did you like most about teaching? I liked nothing. What did you hate? I hated my learners. No, not all of them. Only the smart ones. You know those smart learners that come to school to expose the teacher? Always asking smart questions. I hated those learners. I'm like, every day you ask, but you can see that I don't know. But you are asking. Do I look like Google? Yeah? You know those smart questions? Those smart learners, I hated smart learners. I really did. It got to a point whereby I took all the smart learners and put them this side. And I focused on my sweet ones this side. Those who never ask. Because I was trained, guys. I didn't just become a teacher. I was trained. For 4 years, they trained me on how to become a teacher. And they told me that before you go to class, you prepare a lesson. You teach the learners. When you are done, you ask them questions to check if they understand. They didn't tell me that the learners would ask me as well. No, guys. That's why I became a stand-up comedian, because the audience never asks anything. The day you start asking questions, I'll quit, Bob. Do you want to expose me? No, it doesn't work like that. It doesn't work like that. And so now I'm doing this comedy. But I don't know if you know Leon Schuster. You know Leon Schuster? Yes. I was inspired by Leon. As a kid, I used to watch Leon. I just want to be this. I don't want to be funny. I don't want to be rich. I just want to be famous like Leon so that I can have permission to break people's stuff. Because Leon can come in here and break the lights here. When you are angry, I'm Leon. Leon, for what? You've broken my light. I could imagine myself going to ShopRite. I wouldn't waste my time with breaking, no. I'll just go to Shekhar's when I'm hungry. I take 2 kg chicken and I put it here, like here. But if you put 2 kg chicken here, you have to be very brave because 2 kg chicken is cold. Walk on your toes towards the exit. And if the security guard notices, I'll just laugh. Don't be so silly, it's a joke. I'm Leon. There's a camera there, there's a camera there. That time, there's no camera, but it's just me and my poverty. My mother doesn't like comedy. She always asks me, Kanyisa, is it true that in Joburg you're involved in a scam that makes people pay for laughing? And then I'm, no, this is bad. Laughter comes from God. You mean people can leave their homes, they come to you, they give their money so that they can laugh? Yo, I'll stay here. Here, we still laugh for free. Hey! But I love my mother. I really love my mother. I've been trying to embark on a course on a weight loss program. As you can see, it's not been working. But I'm never going to give up. Never. You know, there's a product, I don't know. Guys, where are you going? In my class, you come to me and say, please, ma'am, may I go out? It's fine, I'll forgive you because it's your first time. Your first time offenders. There's this product called Herbex. Guys, you know Herbex? I wanted to buy Herbex. Like, I was so convinced that I'm going to buy the product. But there was this guy that did a testimony about Herbex. This is what he said. I used to weigh 300 kilograms. Like, you? 300? I'm still slender. 300! He went on and said, I started using Herbex. Within 6 months, I lost 100 kilograms. Like, yo! I weigh 100 kilograms right now. What's going to happen to me after 6 months? After 6 months, I'm going to disappear. No, I never used Herbex. That's why you still see me here today, fully visible. Otherwise, you'd be hearing voices. They say she's over there. No, guys, I'm here, fully visible. I felt very sad when I heard about people dying in cyclones. Because as a geography teacher, I used to teach people about my learners about cyclones. But I feel so useless. Because I taught them everything about cyclones, formation, speed, duration, lasts up 2 to 3 days. It can travel up to 63 km per hour. It forms over moist, warm oceans. But I didn't teach them the most crucial thing. What should you do when a cyclone comes? Because why should you teach learners about formation? They taught me about formation as well. It's not like I've got an ambition of forming my own cyclone. No, man, this is wrong. They must teach us stuff that we are going to use. On that note, talking about my mother is a fan of Generations. Who watches Generations here? You still do? You watch Generations? Who watches Generations? Please be honest. Please come here with your chair. Please, we don't have much time. Can you please bring your chair? We don't have much time. Can you please give her a round of applause? Hey, you are wild, ne? I thought you were going to go that way. Okay, it's fine. But my mother doesn't come there. Like when she comes, gets on stage, she goes like this. But anyway, sit here. Just relax. I'll be with you. My mother watches Generations, guys. And please now, we're talking about my mother is an elderly person. You just stop laughing now, or else you're going to have bad luck. My mother is a fan of Generations. Yo, my mother loves Generations. I don't know if you watched during the times of Capella. Remember Capella? Yo. My mother loved Capella so much that when she prayed, she included Capella in her prayers. Oh, God, please be with the Capella. Let him have a good wife. Let him leave this Katie. And I used to kneel next to my mother. Mama, we've got serious problems here at home. You're busy praying for Capella. Then Kapela died, right? Remember Kapela died? My mother cried for days. She was inconsolable. My father called me, said, Kaisa, please come home and talk to your mother. For the sake of this joke, can you please be my mother? My mother's got hair like yours. I need two things from you. Just gonna cry. Guys, please, take this as an audition. Like, you've always wanted to be on Generations. And I would like you to be judges. Please, guys, be fair. We want to check if there's talent here or not. Only two things. Ooh, ukapela. Judges, take your positions. One, two. Okay, take your seat and go. Any talent here? Thank you. You've made it. Tomorrow, 11 o'clock, we're shooting. Ne? You got the role. You got the role. Give a round of applause. I found my mother crying. I went straight to Mama, please stop crying. These things that you see on TV, don't take them seriously. Kapela is not dead. Kapela is pretending to be dead. He's just an actor. He's an entertainer. So they pay him to pretend to be dead, Mama. Please, man, don't do this. In fact, Mama, to be honest, Kapela doesn't even exist. It's just a character they created to entertain us. My mother was so relieved. Hey, Kanyisa, thank you very much. I'm lucky to be your mother because now I'm well informed. Last year, April, she called me. She was laughing. Hey, Kanyisa, you should hear this one. Everyone in the village, they are crying. They think that Winnie Mandela is dead. Yeah. Mama, I want to say something. No, don't worry. Don't say anything. I've got this. I'm your mother. I tell my friends in the village that these things that you see on TV, don't take them seriously. Winnie Mandela is not dead. She's pretending to be dead because she's an entertainer. They pay her to pretend. In fact, to be honest, Winnie doesn't even exist. It's just a character they created to entertain us. My name is Kanye Sapunu. Thank you very much. I'm not touchy-touchy.